Check, 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 1, 2, check.
Everyone good? All right. I want to thank everyone here today for attending this press conference. We've all watched several press conferences today, but right now we have our words and our statements that we want to share with the public. But first and foremost, I want to thank Tillman Fertitta, who opened his heart and his home, his hotel, for this beautiful family. You know, I'm not from Houston. However, I've found Houston a very lovely community with great leadership and very supportive in every way I could say it. You know, when I asked for a place where we can host this press conference, and he said yes, and he put us in his ballroom, you know, it spoke volumes about the community in Houston, the leadership in Houston, the hearts in Houston, and all those who have continued to support this beautiful family. And we also have today Chief of Police of Houston, Art Acevedo, who has also continued to be supportive of this family, not for any purpose, but other than this family is a reflection of Houston, the community in Houston, immigrants, people work hard, people join our military, and I see how this this family has been supported by this community, by leaders, by law enforcement, by everyone, and that speaks volumes about your leadership and your community and your community leader. So I want to give this microphone right now to Tillman Fertitta, and I want to thank him again.
Thank you so much. You know, it's amazing what people can do in this world. And when you had this incident, this horribly tragic incident, it was just going to go away like so many brutal murders that happened throughout this country and in our community. And because of Vanessa's family, and her great friends at Chavez, they just didn't let it go away. And it touched my huge Hispanic workforce. It touched me. And what they did was just unbelievable, and how they just pounded on it and pounded on it. And I know how I operate. And I had so much respect for the family and the friends. And look where we are today, the changes that have come because of this, because of her family and her friends that refuse to let this go away, that we are making changes in this country that are going to last for generations to come. And we all talk about, I don't want somebody's death to be in vain. This one for sure isn't. That her family for generations also will know what a change her death and how this is a better place for all of us to live in. My heart goes out to these people. I saw them the day at Chavez when Vanessa was laid out, and I just have so much respect for all of them and all of their family and for her so special friends that would not let it go away. Thank you.
Houston's Chief of Police, Art Acevedo, please give us a few words too.
Thank you, Natalie, and thank you, Tillman, for, you know, just being a community leader. And I think Natalie hit it on the head that you open your doors, you open your home, and you open your heart. And people are wondering, why is the Houston Police Chief involved? And that's because whether it's George Floyd that was taken from this community unjustly, Vanessa was taken. And, you know, we have been a big part of the debate here in Houston, the police department talking about relational policing and talking about the importance of our community, whether you're documented or undocumented, born here, born overseas. And from day one, the day that the military came and Father Tomas came, called me, and the military was coming over to say they identified the remains, we were there. I was there. And it's an honor and a privilege to be here. But I think that the point that I want to make is that when a person is victimized and taken from us, that there's no more powerful force than love of family and advocacy from a counsel and an attorney that knows what she's doing. And so I want to tell the family, I want to tell the community that if you are a victim, come forward. Our department has stood with this family like we stood with the Floyd family. And I want to say on behalf of all of us and all the victims that will not be victimized without justice, thank you for your courage. Thank you for your advocacy. Y a la señora, la familia Guillén, quiero decirle, como le dije del primer día, gracias por el amor de la mamá y del papá de la familia, que por su coraje, por sus esfuerzos, su niña está en el cielo con el Dios, pero ustedes van a salvar vidas. And they have made changes that can only been unimaginable. They've moved the United States Army, and that is a pretty hard force to move. So congratulations, and here's to continue to honor the memory of Vanessa by making good things happen for the next generation of soldiers. Hey? Acabo de hablar en español. Al final podemos contestar preguntas.
Thank you, Art. And, you know, he said something that was really true. You know, today we've all learned and heard about the changes that the Department of Defense, the Department of the Army will be taking and implementing. We spoke today by Zoom with Secretary McCarthy. It was our first time meeting and speaking with him, and it was much appreciated. I said this was the last piece of the puzzle that we needed to accomplish. Vanessa's memory and what happened to Vanessa has created such incredible change in this community, in the military community, and in our country at large. We have so many people who come out and speak. Their voices are heard now. Before it was, no one was believed. You heard the stats today by the report that came out, a couple hundred pages, and it talked about how many victims never reported, or the ones that were reported, how many were investigated. And I gotta say, it's so nice, it's refreshing to hear the truth. The truth was sad, it was upsetting, but it was refreshing. And I think we all needed this. We all wanted to know the truth. It's time that our country moves together, mobilizes together. Like I said, I'm not in the military, But I felt like this was a very important cause. I support our troops. I support our military. I support our veterans. Everyone should, because we're here because of them. And we can all contribute to this cause. We all can be part of this. You know, we have the Me Too movement for women and victims out there of sexual harassment, sexual assault. This is considered the Me Too movement for the military. And I'm honored and I'm proud to be behind it. And I think we're moving forward together. And everybody is watching. I mean, someone tells me it's trending. I don't even know what that means, but I think it's funny. It's trending. This is trending. What does that mean? That means that everybody's listening. Everybody's watching. Everybody cares. And that's important. Vanessa's death will not be in vain. It will live with us forever. And we're all going to be part of making that change, making that difference, not just in the community locally, but in our country and the system at large. I just ask everybody to do me one favor, because we're not finished our mission. I ask everybody to please stand behind the Vanessa Guillén Act. Please stand behind supporting that legislation. Because without that legislation, we're just going to keep on having statistics. We're just keep on having numbers. We're just going to keep on having victims and deaths. And we can't afford that. We cannot lose another soldier. Not again. It's not fair. We cannot afford to lose another Vanessa. And the only way to fix that is through legislation. You know, I said awareness is very important, but awareness doesn't fix it. Legislation fixes it. And we need our Congress to step up and vote on that bill and pass that bill, so that way our soldiers can sleep at night and not be in fear, not be afraid of retaliation, not be afraid that they are going to be discharged because they said something or said the wrong thing. So I'm going to give this speaker to this. Who are we going to do? Myra? I'm going to give the microphone to Myra. Myra Guillén, Vanessa's older sister. And she's going to say a few words about how we felt today and what we experienced today with these reports and these results.
Hi, I want to thank everyone for coming today. And of course, I want to prioritize Natalie for being our legal help through the whole run, and also Chief of Police Art Acevedo for always supporting us emotionally and in whatever ways he's able to, and also Mr. Tillman for opening his doors for us to be able to be here today and to be able to accomplish this press conference. It is going to be a long 8 months, and you know, we keep going as hard as it gets. There's nothing that we wouldn't want to go back, and none of this have to have happened, but we're here today, and Vanessa has made a great impact. As long as we have, we're going to keep pushing. We're going to keep asking for the legislation to be passed in order to be able to help all these military members that need our help. We don't need this to happen again. And we're, I guess you could say, satisfied with what the investigation did release today. There was individuals that we asked for them to be removed, and they have been removed. Now it's for us to keep on asking for justice, to find those who are responsible and keep the investigation going to see who has to be held accountable. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Lupe Guillen. I'm Vanessa's youngest sister, and first and off, I want to thank Natalie. It has been a long journey. I want to thank Mr. Tillman because it's a great support, and especially Mr. Acevedo because he has been with us through this long process. And as many as y'all know, I believe now on December 22nd is going to be 8 months. And you just hear 8 months, you just hear a long process. And it saddens me that, as Natalie mentioned, that we talked to the Secretary of the Army, Mr. McCarthy, via Zoom, but it really saddens me because it took around 7.5 months for him to talk to us, and I do not think it was his call. I believe he needed to talk to us before this press conference, since the findings of the independent panel, But I do want to mention about what Mr. Jack White said in the Independent Panel in the Pentagon about the sexual violence being one of the highest in Fort Hood. And I heard so many numbers that sometimes I really got confused. I heard many numbers everywhere. But what actually stuck out to me was that they investigated more than 500 female soldiers. And I believe 100 of them are actually being sexually harassed, and yet they're not reporting it, just like Vanessa, due to retaliation, due to harassment, due to them being afraid and being removed, and then their military career goes down, and then it comes out to mind, and they say, Vanessa Guillén. I do remember and I do recall that CID said that there was no sexual harassment found in my sister's case, and yet here we go again today. Why she didn't report it? Because of retaliation. And she was afraid of that. And I always hear this saying, protect our woman. We cannot protect our woman without respecting our woman. And I'm not only saying this as a victim of this crime, I'm saying this as a woman, as someone who wanted to sign up for the military. And if Mr. McCarthy watches this, I hope you actually endorse the I Am Vanessa Guillén bill, because in my mindset, I don't think you have to read it to support it, because you just hear Vanessa Guillén, you hear her murder and her disappearance and her sexual harassment. And I hope Congress, as Natalie mentioned, takes action, because this is needed. This is not about your political views. This is about human issues, just like Vanessa, and we don't want another soldier going missing. We don't want another victim of sexual harassment end up murdering, and for suicide rates to go down. And what else could I say? That we are not going to stop until we pass the I Am Vanessa Guillén Act, because it's necessary. And as mentioned, it happens both to men and women. So please, I ask the public that is watching this, I ask everyone who hears about Vanessa's name or hears about sexual violence in the military or anywhere to endorse the bill, the act, I mean, because this will keep my sister's legacy alive. And believe me that it will save lives. It will save lives. And one more thing. There's an article out there going on that it says more than 200 soldiers have gone missing at Fort Hood Army Base since 2016. More than 200 soldiers. And I just want to quick do the math, you know. More than 200 soldiers going missing. That means, averagely, one soldier goes missing a week. And that soldier ends up dead. And yet the U.S. Army does not ask themselves, why is this happening? Why does someone commit suicide? Why does someone commit murder? Or why does someone do not report sexual violence? And we have the answer. The SHARP program does not work, and that's what we need the I Am Vanessa Guillén Act to pass. Why do soldiers commit suicide? Their mental health, the toxic leadership, and thank God that those leaderships at Fort Hood, 14 of them, were removed, and Evelyn deserved it because he ignored us every single time that passed by, overland. He was so disrespectful throughout this process. And I'm sorry to say this, which I'm not the person to say this, but you deserve it. And I hope for Vanessa's line of command to be investigated and to be held accountable. And for the woman out there in jail, we're going to fight for Vanessa Guillén, for you to stay in jail where you belong. So please, I plead that pass the I Am Vanessa Guillén Act, and for her to be investigated, and for my sister's story to not go in vain, and for other soldiers. So we demand justice for our soldiers and justice for Vanessa Guillén, and to respect our female soldiers who put their life at risk. Thank you. Voy a hacer un resumen en español pequeño. Nomás estamos pidiendo justicia. Pero mi mamá va a dar las palabras ahorita en español, ella va a hablar. So ahorita vamos a pasarle el micrófono a mi mamá, Gloria Guillén.
Um, Antes que nada, yo como siempre les digo, hay que darle gracias a Dios de que nos dio un día más y agradecerle a todos a ustedes que están aquí, al señor Acevedo, al señor que apenas lo acabo de conocer, otro señor, no sé ni cómo se llama. Nosotros hemos luchado desde el 22 de abril, desde que fue secuestrada mi hija Vanessa. Ahí hemos luchado, primero porque se encontrara, yo la quería encontrar viva. No se logró encontrar viva, se encontró asesinada en una base militar, porque fue adentro de la base militar de Fort Hood, por eso se ha llegado hasta donde se ha llegado, porque se cometió ese horrible asesinato, que en el peor de los criminales se merece morir como murió mi hija, porque la torturaron, le hicieron lo que quisieron y la asesinaron. Por eso yo juré ante tu tumba que yo no iba a parar hasta dar con los verdaderos responsables y que todos cayeran y se pudrieran en la cárcel. Para mí esto que se acaba de hacer ahorita es un paso, faltan varios. Yo le dije ahorita al señor, el secretario del ejército, que ahorita acabamos de asum, sí, está muy bien, los bajaron, los quitaron a unos, pero no, yo quiero cárcel y que se descubra la verdad de lo que realmente pasó. ¿Qué es lo que pasó con mi hija? ¿Por qué fue ese horrible asesinato con mi hija? No fue una cucaracha, fue un ser humano inocente y limpio al que asesinaron. Y no nomás a ella, a varios soldados. Fort Hood es un corrupto. Fort Hood es de lo peor que haya existido para mí, porque ahí murió mi hija. Nada se me podrá devolver, con nada lo que haga no se podrá devolver mi niña, ni mi sufrimiento que he llevado día con día, noche con noche. Yo espero en Dios que se haga justicia y que esto que ha pasado ahorita, faltan 3 investigaciones o 2 creo, la criminalista y otra. Espero en Dios que la criminalista me den a mí la verdad, los nombres de los responsables, de los verdaderos responsables del asesinato de Vanessa Guillén. Porque ese miserable dice que se suicidó Robinson, para mí no se suicidó, lo asesinaron porque él iba a hablar. Iba a echar de cabeza a los verdaderos responsables. ¿Qué existe en Fort Hood? ¿Qué hay en Fort Hood? ¿Qué tan grande pudo haber mirado a mi hija? Supo. Aparte de ser acosada sexualmente. Porque fue acosada sexualmente. A mí me lo dijo. Ella le tenía miedo al comando. Ella le tenía miedo al general, al ese asqueroso. Yo quiero saber la verdad. Como madre, la familia, la abogada, queremos la verdad y quiero que ese vil de Vanessa Guillén sea pasado. ¿Para qué? Porque así se van a proteger miles, millones de soldados. Que tuvo que morir una inocente que fue mi hija para que esta para que existe lo que existe en el ejército, maldad, crueldad, abuso contra los pobres jóvenes. ¿Por qué no muere un capitán, un comandante, un general? ¿Por qué un soldado joven, inocente, como mi hija? Es lo que no entiendo. ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué ella murió? ¿Por qué ella de jovencita, niña, le hicieron lo que le hicieron esos miserables? Se va a saber la verdad porque se va a saber la verdad. Porque los ojos de toda una nación y del mundo están puestos en el caso de Vanessa Guillén. Es lo que le dije ahorita al secretario de Defensa. Están puestos. Y esto se tiene que saber, porque si no, yo como le he pedido, cero alistamiento en el ejército, hasta que no lleguemos a la verdad y se pasen las leyes de que se hagan responsables de proteger a sus soldados, cuidarlos, protegerlos, y que exista una ley que los proteja, como la ley de Vanessa Guillén. Esa niña inocente que hizo historia, y va a ser historia por siempre, mi niña. Y yo y mi familia hemos luchado, y la abogada, y no vamos a parar hasta llegar a la verdad. Yo, que soy la madre, que yo la amaré y por siempre la amaré. Y nunca se devolverá a mi hija. Yo la veo en fotos, en videos, en pinturas, en murales. Pero a mí nunca se devolverá esa niña. Esa niña que era mi vida. Que yo siempre andábamos juntas por donde quiera. Por eso pido cárcel de por vida para todos esos miserables. Y la que está en la cárcel, la miserable que participó, ahí es que se pudra. Yo quiero que se pudra allí. y todos los responsables. A mí no me convencen con que los bajaron, que los quitaron. Yo no soy conforme. Yo no quiero que se pudran en la cárcel todos esos miserables. Que hubo un complot del comando para mi hija. Y yo desde siempre se los dije. Nadie me creía. ¿Por qué ha llegado hasta donde ha llegado? Porque es la verdad de lo que está pasando en Fort Hood. Es la verdad de lo que dije yo. Por eso les digo, hagamos justicia, sigamos en esta lucha. Falta la investigación criminal que me prometió el general que juega a mi casa, que él me iba a decir hablar con la verdad. Ya terminó su investigación, la cambió para otra parte. Espero en Dios y hablen con la verdad, porque Dios, para Dios no hay nada oculto y todo se sabrá. Aquí en la tierra todos pagarán y en el infierno se irán todos los que participaron en el asesinato de mi hija. Tan cruel, cruel, que mataron a esa niña inocente, pura y limpia. Llegamos a la verdad por el amor de Dios. Lleguen a la verdad y entréguenme los verdaderos responsables y que se pudran en la cárcel. Les agradezco a todos por estar aquí y sigamos adelante y que nunca me dejen sola hasta llegar a la verdad. Dios los bendiga y muchísimas gracias.
I want to ask first, does anyone have any questions? I know we didn't really discuss the reports or anything, but that was really emotional. Steve? I can't hear you. Someone communicate that?
Mayra, ayer publicaste en tu cuenta de Twitter que te estaba hirviendo la sangre y que no estabas contenta con lo que se había adelantado ayer. Ahorita escuché que dijiste que estás un poco satisfecha con lo que se reportó ya hoy. ¿Qué cambió de ayer a hoy? ¿O qué escuchaste hoy que te hizo decir que ya estás un poco satisfecha con lo que pasó?
So, básicamente, descubrimos algunos nombres de algunos que estaban en el comando, en la línea de comando de Vanessa, que sí fueron relevados de su puesto desde el más alto hasta el más bajo. Y eso fue algo que me dio un poco de satisfacción, porque a partir de mañana ellos van a empezar a considerar todas las acciones que ellos no tomaron para poder encontrar a Vanessa más pronto, que se tuvo que tardar 2 meses para dar con ella. Y cómo fue que ellos fallaron desde el principio de no hablar y no avisarnos a nosotros hasta el día de hoy. Solo espero que ahora puedan comprender un poco lo que nosotros pasamos y es por eso que ya hoy, dándome cuenta sobre quién fue despedido, son cosas que ayudan un poco. Este solamente fue Robinson. A partir de ahí, los que me esperaron el primer día eran soldados como de la edad de mi hermana, no eran que estaban a cargo. De ellos no sé mucho, pero por lo que sí sé es que espero que hayan sido también relevados los que mintieron en el reporte del día que dijeron que ya que miraron a Vanessa a las 1:00 p.m, que no fue cierto.
Question for you two. It's been 8 months later this month. If Vanessa was looking down, what do you think she'd say to you about your guys' continued efforts, about your relentlessness, about so many people have looked on and just been in awe of your family and the determination you've shown? Oh. Because Chief Acevedo said you guys moved the United States Army to act.
That question was very emotional. You know, I always wear this pin. I always do. And I think that answer could be that she would never expect me to be up here in front of like 20 cameras and speak to the nation, because I was a very shy person and she knows it. But I do believe that she's proud of what we're doing, that she's the type of person that cares about another person, even though they don't know each other. I believe she's very happy that not many of other victims of sexual violence are going through the same thing that she went through, you know, telling her mom and not telling her mom what's actually happening to her. And I believe she's very proud of us, proud of not only myself, not only Myra, but my whole family and the community coming together. But I want to add something that wherever you are, Vanessa, you are alive. You are here today. Your legacy is going to keep going, hopefully with the act that we're trying to pass. And you know that as sisters, we're going to fight for you because that's family for us. And not only yourself, but for everyone out there, every other female soldier that's going through the same process, like the independent panel said, we believe you. I believe you. And I'm fighting this for Vanessa as her sister, but I'm fighting for this as a woman and as someone who wanted to sign up for the U.S. Army. But thank you for the question, and just remember that I love you, Vanessa. Steve, de ABC 13, me preguntó una pregunta muy emocional, que ¿qué pensaría yo y Myra de lo que está pasando? ¿Qué pensaría Vanessa de nosotros? Y yo le dije que es una pregunta muy emocional porque siempre me toca el corazón esas preguntas. Pero yo le dije que siempre cargo este pin que dice justicia para Vanessa Guillén en mi corazón, porque siempre va a estar en mi corazón. Pero Vanessa sabe que yo era muy timidiosa, no me gustaba hablar, y ahora estoy hablando de enfrente de 20 cámaras y con muchas personas que no conozco. Y yo creo que ella está muy, muy agradecida por lo que estoy haciendo, y nada más por ella, por otros soldados. Y ella, yo digo que ella está feliz para que otros soldados no pasen lo mismo que ella pasó.
Well, next steps are focusing on Congress. We'll be back up in D.C. Hopefully right after inauguration, perhaps the 21st. I'm not going to be wasting any time. And demand that we get a date scheduled on the calendar, on a congressional calendar. You know, I'm calling every day Congress, different congressmen, congresswomen, service senators, Nancy Pelosi's office. I mean, I'm sure they love when I give them a call. But, you know, it's this advocacy, this diligence, this persistence, that's how we get the job done. You know, everyone says, well, people have been trying to do this for years and never worked. And I said, you know, I don't know when's the last time I slept well. But it's worked. And I got to say, we just got to continue doing this. You know, we don't have any days off until this legislation gets passed, because there's no guarantees without this legislation. Everyone's out there without any protections right now. And again, I am so incredibly grateful to the Secretary and General Richardson, and the way everyone has General McConville today. I got to tell you, that man really showed what great leadership he has. He was very compassionate. He told us that whatever we're going to need, we can get. For example, we want to go back to the crime scene. Like, how did that happen in 43 minutes? I'm still confused. So they're opening their gates to us. They're allowing us to review what happened, because I don't think this family has that closure yet. It's very difficult for us to understand. I think everyone wants to know what happened, how that happened. So the fact that they're keeping this open line communication with us, they said that they will not let this family be in the dark anymore. Any questions that we have, they will answer. You know, I've asked some very straight, uncomfortable questions today, and I got answers. And, you know, I was told that in addition to the 14 soldiers, that a few of the CID agents were also terminated. That's not in the press. You know, they're just giving us a lot more information than ever before. And we asked Secretary McCarthy to sponsor, support our bill. Now, mind you, we don't need his support, okay? That's not how a bill works. We need Congress to support it, He thought it was going to be in the NDAA. It's not in the NDAA. It's a standalone bill. So that means that we need two-thirds of Congress to support the bill, and I think we can do it. Why I asked for the secretary to support it, because I want to know his position. I think we all want to know. Do you think that there needs to be change or not? You know, I always say put your money where your mouth is, or where your pen is, and sign a dotted line. So he asked for a copy of the bill. I'm going to give it to him. And he said he might only have 23 days left. I think he said 23 days or something. He said he had 23 days left, maybe, maybe not. And I said, that's all right. We got 23 days to make that decision. Better late than never. So we have a big task at hand, and that's to get a bill passed. It's not going to be the first time I got a bill passed. I'm the girl for the job, and I'm ready to do it.
Esta pregunta es para la familia. ¿Cómo reaccionan ustedes después que los investigadores de esta investigación, valga la redundancia, dijeron de que no encontraron en esta investigación evidencia que demuestre que Vanessa Guillén fue acusada o abusada sexualmente? La mamá, por favor.
Mal, porque claramente lo dije desde un principio. Yo, a mí mi hija me lo confesó, que estaba siendo acosada sexualmente por un sargento. Y yo les dije, no me creían. ¿Y ahorita qué salió a la luz? ¿Cuántas muchachas han sido acosadas en Fort Hood? O sea, ¿por qué están diciendo todo? Ven lo que ven, y todas se atreven a decir que mi hija no hay pruebas de que fue acosada. Fue acosada sexualmente. El asesinato de ella, ¿por qué fue? Es lo que yo quiero saber. ¿Qué miró tan grave? ¿Qué supo tan grave que llegó a ese grado de asesinarla? ¿Un acoso sexual llega tanto? Mi hija fue acosada, a mí me lo dijo. Y yo, a quien sea, se lo certifico. Que eso pongan ellos. Sí, fue acosada y fue acosada. Y cuando digo yo algo, ¿qué, por qué estamos aquí? ¿Por qué el secretario del ejército salió a la luz? ¿Por qué el general? ¿Por qué? Porque está saliendo la verdad, porque tienen miedo a todo lo que está pasando, porque tienen miedo a que si los jóvenes ya no se escriban. ¿Tanto suicidio? ¿Por qué? Porque los acosan, los violan, los hostigan. A mí eso mi hija me decía. En 9 meses que lleva ella sirviendo allí en Fort Hood, me dijo, mami, se han suicidado 8 jóvenes. ¿Por qué se suicidan, mi hija? Porque los acosan, los hostigan. Y yo creo que hasta los han violado, mami. No me decía el acoso sexual a mí hasta después. O sea, esto va a llegar a otra parte, que entiendan. Va a llegar a donde tenga que llegar. Gracias.
Quiero añadir algo a su pregunta, que por qué dicen que Vanessa nunca sufrió acoso sexual. Vanessa sí sufrió el acoso sexual y lo sufrió con Robinson. Vamos a ser claramente. Robinson, Aaron David Robinson, acosó a Vanessa sexualmente porque entró al baño cuando ella se estaba bañando. Y lo vamos a hacer, el ejército no nunca va a admitir que Vanessa fue acosada sexualmente, porque ellos quieren su apariencia a los Estados Unidos, que se miren bien. El ejército se quiere mirar bien, pero con nosotros no se van a mirar bien. Y como dijo Jack White en el independiente panel, la investigación, muchos de ellos no reportan el acoso sexual, fear of retaliation. Tienen miedo a la línea de comando, tienen miedo a reportarlo. ¿Por qué? Porque muchos presencian que, como Vanessa Guillén, ella presenció a muchas muchachas que fueron ignoradas, y por eso ella dijo, ¿por qué lo voy a reportar si me van a ignorar? Pero ella sí fue acosada sexualmente por 3 personas o más en diferentes ocasiones en la base militar de Fort Hood. Eso sí lo puedo asegurar.
I have a question regarding the investigation. Who's currently in control of the investigation right now?
Which investigation are you referring to?
Well, to answer the questions that the family is asking regarding Vanessa Guillén's sexual harassment cases.
Okay, so let me just clarify. There's 4 ongoing, or 4 ones completed today. Investigations. There's a congressional investigation by the Oversight Committee. There's the special investigation that we're discussing today with the findings. There's Mary's investigation, General Mary's investigation, which is Futures Command, I think it's called. And then there was an internal investigation that they had at Fort Hood that we didn't really care too much about. What is the question in reference to this one? Then there's also obviously the government's investigation, which is right now still ongoing. We have a date in January for Cecily Aguilar.
Okay, well, to make my question more clear is, which investigation is providing more leads, and will the investigation ever be in the hands of the family, or will be at some point?
I don't understand what you mean by that.
Will the family be able to investigate themselves? Or not?
Will we be able to? We already have the reports. I'm sorry, so I'm not understanding.
Okay. I guess which investigation is providing more leads or answers to the families?
Okay, so the last investigation that they had internally, I call it the Mickey Mouse investigation, that let's just put that aside. The special investigation that came out today, I felt like was very good. It was detail-oriented. I actually do look forward to General Mary's investigation that should be coming out. It's already completed. And we understand that, we asked the secretary when it's going to be coming out. He said it should be like in the next week. Did he say? Okay, within the next few weeks, we should have General Mary's investigation. That one I actually think we're going to learn a lot from, because that's going to be an investigation on the command when the murder happened and what happened and how they handled it. So the investigation today gave us a lot of information input, I think, about Fort Hood in general. You know, they talked about the stats and the reports and everything. So the investigation today was more of a generic investigation. The one coming up for General Mary's is going to be more detailed about Vanessa's murder and the way that they handled or mishandled this case. You know what, I think, and going back to the whole, I don't know if we're ever going to know everything with what happened that day, because the two people that were there are no longer with us. However, you know, we can go with what we assumed happened, being the hearsay that we've been given, and just a date and time of things. I feel like it's important that we do our own investigation. I call a spade, you know, like, these are my clients. I represent them. I'm their advocate, and I'm going to find out the truth on their behalf, not what's going to sound good or nice or warm and fuzzy. So I'd like to, that's why we've asked for our right to be on the base to do our own processing of this. And I've already spoken to several soldiers off the record, you know, that I would, you know, protect their identity. About what happened that day and what they saw and such. So, you know, I want everyone to do their investigation. The more, the better, because it just provides us more details and facts. We can negate whatever we don't agree with. We can adopt whatever we believe. But overall, I think that this is a good opportunity for us to figure out what happened, and hoping in our best way possible it never happens again. What's
that? What do you expect from the criminal investigation?
What do I expect from the criminal investigation? Mm-hmm. Are you talking about the Department of Justice's U.S.
Yes.
Attorney's Office?
About the specific about Vanessa Guillén case. When we expecting the results? When
oh,
we expecting
results? Jeez, I don't think we're going to get results. We're going to get a lot of trial if she continues to, you know, challenge and not admit. You know, not do some kind of agreement with a U.S. Attorney's Office. We're gonna hopefully get her on the stand and hear what she saw, what she knew. But this could be years, unfortunately. You see how the system is. That's why I didn't want to bring this family through that system. I'm not saying that the system is bad. I'm just saying that the system is very slow. And so not many people can say, let's go straight to Congress, let's go straight to the White House, let's go straight. But that's what this family needed. They needed answers, and they needed them fast. I can't hear. I'm sorry.
Sorry. Who can you hear me better like this?
Yeah.
Natalie, overall, can you please repeat in English? Overall, are you guys satisfied with the review, the findings, and is there anything else that was not found or not talked about that you guys would like to see addressed?
Can you say that loudly so everyone can hear you?
Staff has overall with the findings and the report, and there's something that you want
I can
to
answer
hear.
The question.
Yeah? Okay. Lupe is going to answer that question.
Okay.
You know, I believe not only myself, but the whole family acknowledges the Army's effort to, you know, to find more negative problems at Fort Hood. But, you know, it's not only involving Fort Hood, it involves the whole U.S. Army. And to be truly honest, I don't think we're satisfied, you know. To start off by the Secretary of the Army, I don't think that's very professional of himself to give a Zoom call before a press conference after 7 months and a half. What was his excuse to not talk to us? So one of the steps we want to take is to meet with him in person. It doesn't matter if he has to come over here. It doesn't matter if we have to travel to Fort Hood or to D.C., but we're not satisfied with the findings. But in one part, I'm thankful that we found that there's more sexual harassment victims for the Army to not say that they didn't find sexual harassment when it was under Major General Scott Effenin's leadership. And now it ends up that we have sexual harassment victims. So you see, one of the problems is the toxic leadership, but we're not satisfied. That's why we will be satisfied until the act passes, until the legislation passes, and until we get actual accountability, answers, and justice for Vanessa Guillén.
I want to add to that. You know, I got to tell you, I don't like throwing darts, but I can understand this family's frustration with the delay in meeting with the Secretary of the Army. You know, they have every right to be disappointed that it took this long. And, you know, I'd like to say that we did get to speak with him. And hopefully this will be a step in the right direction. However, I think it's necessary that they do meet with him. And not only meet with him, I said to him, I'm going to send him our bill so he can review. So when we do meet with him, he can tell us that he agrees with and supports this bill. Again, going back to the whole, we don't need his support. I want his support. I want everyone's support. Because I want to hear and know that you practice what you preach. If you're going to tell me that the Army's messed up or the Fort Hood's messed up or something's wrong, tell me what you're doing to fix it. You know, I had plenty of time to discuss this with several members of Congress that were doing the investigation. And, you know, I got to say, like, when I first started with Fort Hood to investigate it, it didn't start with Vanessa's case. It started with military mold at that base. You know, there's a lot of great families, military families, that have suffered because of the toxicity at that base. And unfortunately, the toxicity isn't just in the homes, it's in the command. And when somebody speaks up and they get punished for speaking up, that's un-American. And it was widespread at Fort Hood. So things aren't complete. They're not finalized. We're not finished. We're just starting. And that goes for what policies they're going to implement, how they're going to handle these wrongs. Are they going to right all these wrongs? And will they support passage of legislation to permanently fix this? You know, policy is great, but policy can be changed every day. Legislation can't be changed every day. it takes an act of Congress. You know that saying, it takes an act of God or it takes an act of Congress. And that's why I go right for the jugular there. I want to make sure that we change it permanently and it doesn't happen again. All right, I think that we're finished, right? Anyone else have any more questions? All right, thank you so much, and have a beautiful week. Thank you.